Happy birthday, happy birthday, have a happy birthday.
Welcome to Sky Motoring Weekly's first birthday party.
And while we blow out all these candles, you can check out the new Chevrolet Camaro SS.
Check out John's cool new Skoda.
We drive the new Renault Clio and the Lexus RX 450.
And I hitch a ride with some bloke called Jensen.
Have a happy birthday.
Two more real-world electric cars were unveiled to the world this week, and blow us down, we actually wouldn't mind owning these. First up was the Citroën C1 EV, a battery-powered version of the four-seater city car that'll do 70 miles on a charge and cost just under 17 grand. Meanwhile, Renault has been looking into the white van man market with this Kangoo Bebop ZE, or zero emissions, which should take you and your tools 100 miles before stopping for a brew break and a charge when it hits showrooms in 2011.
GM might have killed off Pontiac, but the muscle car lives on in the shape of the new Chevrolet Camaro SS. For just $30,000, you get a 426 brake horsepower, 6.2-litre V8, huge burnout, and, thanks to independent suspension, a car that might just get around corners.
If you just can't wait until the 22nd of May to drive the new VW Golf GTI, fear not, the GTI project is here. After being given a virtual tour of this top secret facility, yeah whatever, you get the chance to drive the new GTI around a huge scale electric track. How cool is that? And because it's online, you don't even have to clear it away when your mum gets fed up. Just make sure that your boss can't see what you're doing. The fastest time is going to a hat for a chance to win a brand new GTI for 3 months. The best that we've managed is 25 seconds. Don't tell the boss.
You heard the one about the Skoda Executive Saloon that can embarrass a BMW 3 Series for both space and specification? Well, it might sound like a joke, but it isn't. I've just taken delivery of the Skoda Superb Elegant Spec. It's a 2-litre diesel with 170 brake horsepower, and it comes with a DSG gearbox, so it should be awesome for doing all my motorway miles. And this car's already a Sky Motoring Awards winner too, so I'm going to spend the next 6 months behind the wheel to find out if this car really is worth handing in the keys to the Beamer and downsizing to a Superb.
Renault has given the Clio a facelift, but as Mickey Rourke will attest, that ain't always a good thing. This baby might have been whacked with the ugly stick, but it drives okay, it's reasonably green, it's adequately comfortable, and it's decent value. As a standard hatch, the brilliant Ford Fiesta has it well beaten, but the hot Clio Renault Sport 200 remains a work of genius, especially if you opt for the cup chassis.
This week, I tried out the new Lexus RX 450h Hybrid, and it's got quite a lot going for it, like more torque than a McLaren SLR when the engines and electric motors are working together, yet lower CO2 emissions than some Superminis, and it all works brilliantly around town where you can drive for up to 2 miles by the power of electricity alone. Head out of town though, and it all starts to fall to pieces. The ride's harsh and crashy, yet it also manages to do a brilliant 1970s Cadillac impression around corners. It's vague, roly-poly, and generally pretty awful. It also looks dull inside. Inside and out, although obviously it is beautifully built. It's packed full of technology too, but one thing that Lexus just can't do is emotion. This is a car that appeals on paper, but in reality, it's just a bit of a disappointment. Great engine though.
It was a good week for the Seat Ibiza. Not only was this stunning Bocanegra version unveiled at the Barcelona Motor Show, the Ibiza Ecomotive also set a fuel consumption record for its class with a staggering 97.4 miles per gallon.
It was a bad week for taste as this one-off Mini was revealed. Designed by Hollywood fashion icons The Blondes, it'll be raffled to raise money for AIDS research at the 2009 Life Ball. Great cause, terrible car.
It was a bad week for three teams in the infamous Gumball 3000. Three cars, including this Bugatti Veyron, were impounded for driving at more than 170 miles an hour across the US highway. The drivers, meanwhile, had to spend a night cuddling up to Big Dave in the local Nick.
Don't miss My Lap of Silverstone with Jensen Button in the Honda S2000 that's now become the Sky Motoring race car.
So thanks to the 60,000 of you who watch this show every week, we'll be keeping up the really hard work. And here's a little reminder of what we've been up to over the last year.
See you next week.
Bye.
You're the best, Dad.
No, you are, son.
Hello, hello, hello.
Let me out!
John, have you seen the pictures of that new Beamer 5 Series Gran Turismo? Don't you think that's a bit of a niche too far?